Hello and welcome to another episode of Quickies, the weekly YouTube tech show that's less about important, useful and timely information about technological advances and more about cursing and talking about bums. Coming up, we've got more of your lovely viewer comments and questions, of course, and a look at the week of tech ahead. But first up, what do you think of the new studio? Got a little sign and everything. I know it's not exactly the CNET setup, but you know, it's a start. Just need to finish colouring it in and stuff and we'll be kosher. So as usual, let's start with what happened this week. Well, of course, we've been in lovely Milan for Oppo's massive European launch. The RX17 Pro and the light version known as the Neo are officially official, and the Pro in particular looks very enticing with its rapid super VOOC charging, funky triple lens camera tech and its snazzy design. Still no word on UK pricing and availability sadly, but here's hoping the wee blight has hit these shores soon. And speaking of great value Asian smartphones, the mighty Xiaomi has officially launched itself here in the UK just yesterday, at the same time unveiling the Mi 8 Pro and the Mi 8 Lite. Go make yourself a lovely cup of bovril and check out my full Mi 8 Pro review right now, after a full week of using it as my personal handset. Right now I am using the beastly Huawei Mate 20 as my full-time phone, so expect a camera review, full tips and tricks guide and all the usual sexy shenanigans coming at your face. And now it's time for the part of the show that's about as thrilling as Theresa May's autobiography. It's viewer comments. So first up, do you think Xiaomi will be successful in the UK? I really hope that it does do well. I mean, just look at brands such as OnePlus, brands that most people wouldn't have even heard of a couple of years ago. They're now becoming more and more popular, grabbing a nice slice of that UK market. I definitely think people are sick of paying premium prices for their smartphones. They definitely want to go on cheaper contracts, maybe get their phones online or through other routes in order to bring down the overall cost. So I think if Xiaomi is smart with its marketing, it could do very well and snatch a nice slice of Samsung's pie. Yum. Next up, dude, are you gonna do more videos with the Moto G6 series or do you hate them too much? Loving the videos anyway, keep it up, Baldy. Thanks, I guess. Still got the Moto G6 and I definitely do not hate it at all, absolutely love it. I think it's one of the best sub £300 smartphones you can get right now for sure. We're going to be doing lots of roundups of the best smartphones that you can buy at specific price points really soon, so stay tuned for some Moto action in those bad boys. Wink, wink. Next up, what is your favourite Android one? Ah, seriously? Okay, right, you've had your chance, sign. Piece of shit. Think CNET people have to put up with this shit? Of course not. So next up, what is your favourite Android One handset? Well, of the ones that I've used so far, definitely still the Nokia 7 Plus. I was a little bit let down by the Nokia 7.1. Felt like more of a step back than anything else, despite the HDR screen. It just didn't have that slick, smooth Android performance, which is a real shame considering it was basically a raw form of the OS. So definitely, in terms of bang for your buck, solid specs and still about sort of £330-340 price point, the Nokia 7 Plus, you can't go wrong. Next up, hey big man, where is the LG V40? Oh God, no more phones. Please God, no more phones. I promise I will hit up LG probably next week to see if I can get a V40 on the go. It does look like quite an interesting phone, to be fair. 5 cameras, who's not impressed by that? I do still have to review, of course, the Mate, the OnePlus 6T, and the Pixel 3 XL, but once I get through all of that, hopefully we'll have time for a nice bit of V40 action. Last up this week, do you watch anime, and if so, which anime? Yes, I do. Probably not a massive shocker, given the super geeky wallpapers I just plastered all over my review phones. I haven't watched any new stuff in a while, so definitely if you guys have any recommendations, let me know in the comments down below. The bat mentaler the better. I like crazy stuff like Dog and Scissors, Watamote, that sort of level of stuff. So yeah, if it's a bit nuts, brilliant. So thank you very much for your comments and questions this week. Don't forget again to hit me up in the comments down below and I will get through as many of those as possible next week. Speaking of next week, what's coming up next week? I'll tell you what's not coming up next week, and that's phone launches. Not a single one. Zip nada. That definitely deserves a little dance of joy. So yeah, nice clean week, so I'm going to try and get through some of that backlog, hopefully fully review the OnePlus 6T and a couple other bits. And of course, this time next week, yeah, another quickies. Something to look forward to, right? So you have yourselves a lovely week, kiddies. Don't forget to hit subscribe if you haven't already, and ding that notifications bell, and yeah, have a good one. Cheers. Love you. Bye. Oh. Oh, f*** you, sign.